Sup peeps, it's the dude from Beast Mode Gaming. Right, this is my heal tank tutorial for Hell Eternal. Sorry I haven't made any videos for a while. It's purely because we've just had like Christmas and we moved house and just some things went by and here we are sort of middle of February. And yeah, I guess it is what it is. Right, so let's go over the build. So I need to go and find my Hell Eternal tank build, wherever it may be. There it is. So it's the same talismans as before. You got the same amount of block. I'll just re-go over this real quick. About 4,000 plus attack rating. Round about there is fine. 656 hit. Because it's a hell dungeon, you must have that. Otherwise, you won't Pazel Glance. Penetration rating. There we are. With your blade, that's what you should have. Let's move on to the block rating. 785. And that's pretty much all there is. Pen, hit, block. That's it. No need for any other stats. Right, health, 83. I'm going to take a Benefaction Tonic, purely because I can. There we are. Right, so let's go over some of these abilities. Some of them are very important for tanks. You need them. So what we got is Contortionist, your active elite. That's very important. Basically, what it does is it removes any sort of hinder or anything like that on you. So if you get impaired or hindered, it instantly removes that. And then you need sleight of hand over here. Everything else is the same. You got the same builders, the same everything, blade hammer, just the same. There is another catch. In this dungeon, if you're afflicting, especially on the last boss, if you're afflicting the boss and he sucks your health right down, also, I think that if there's a shield on him as well, if there's an afflict and a shield and he sucks your health down, under those circumstances, you'll die. Purely because you'll be doing the damage is reflected back to you. So when your health is down to one and you've got an afflict going, you die. So generally what they say is no afflicts on the last boss. These days, I don't really follow that at all because I can just hit my Karma Curio and it'll just take my health straight back up before I die. So I say an afflict is fine. As long as you're not going overboard with like a full afflict DPS build or something, then you'll be absolutely fine. Or a DPS sort of a afflict tank build. Other than that, everything's the same. Yep, as you can see. Another thing I do is I run Vexing Augment purely on my builder, 100% extra hate. That's nice on the boss. I'll explain it as we go. Yeah. So what we're going to do, there's an attack in here called Caldera. You must impair that. The boss is going to suck the DPSs in. If they're not sort of close to the boss, it'll suck them in. So what you want to do is you want to impair that and then Shadow in the Blood. Those are the two things you must impair, Caldera and Shadow in the Blood. I always run three impairs. These days we burn through the mechanics so fast you don't really need three, but rule of thumb, three impairs. Right, that's pretty much it. So yeah, we're good to go. I'll just relay my message to the rest of the group and then we'll begin. So just keep an eye on my cast bars over here. You'll see the boss's cast bars, Caldera. It's a big brown attack, an AoE that will literally kill the DPSs. And Shadow in the Blood, that's a single target on yourself. So you have to take that or you'll die. Right, let's begin. There we are. Okay, so I'll be going. So you see my contortion has removed those chains instantly. There we are, impaired that. Shadow in the Blood, impair that. You see that, I almost missed my impair that time. What you can do, if you're in the middle of a cast, just jump and then hit your impair. It'll just cancel it. Done. And that's the end of Fight 1. Old growth have escaped the attention of our invaders. Right, so what you want to do is, the trick to this fight is because you got contortionist on, when he starts to run away, he'll sort of hinder everybody. That's your cue to hit Art of War and to hinder the shit out of that dude. So every time he tries to move, I'll hinder. You'll see what I mean. And then what we do is, the technique we like to use is what we call the burn method, where we wait for him to put the lens up, occluding lens, and then we hit the buffs on the lens. The healer needs to have reap and sow, and then every time we hit the shield, we just heal up and he takes a lot more damage with the shield up. So it's a bonus. Just making sure my DPSs are ready. Okay, everybody's ready. So we're going in 5 seconds. Okay, here we go. Here comes occluding lens. So we're gonna hit the buffs now. Now he's gonna do fall back, and we killed him. But when he does fall back, what you want to do is you want to impair him, then you'll freeze for a bit, step back, impair him again, step back, impair him again. And then that gives the DPSs like another 5 seconds to whoop his ass, and he'll die much quicker. Not bad. Super easy. The ads in here are so painful. What you can do is you can run 2 tank builds. You can, what I like to do is I like to swap to my regular tank build for this next fight and then swap back again. But you can use this build that I've shown you as a master planner build as well if you want. You don't have to swap technically, but I like to swap because the next guy hits pretty hard and I want to stay friends with my healer. So there we are. Let's kill these dudes. Just gonna whoop some ass. See, they do a shield, but it's not as strong as what the shield is in Elite. In Elite, we would have all been dead by now. And you can't impair them in Nightmare. That's another thing. In Elite, you can impair those. So you can't impair any shields in Nightmare. That's another tip. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna equip my regular tank build for this. Whoops. Regular tank build. What you want to do also while I do that is you want to make sure that your DPSs stay outside. They don't want to come inside at all until we have the boss inside this first little well. What we're going to do is we're going to go in a clockwise direction. And I mean, some people go anti-clockwise because it's closer to the gate. But to be honest, these days we don't even need to move the boss. We just burn him and he dies where he stands. That's how easy it is. The level of DPS these days is so good. So what we're going to do is you're going to tell your DPSs not to come in until the boss is in the well. And once that's done, they can run in and come and DPS the boss. Okay, going in 5 seconds. Okay, going. These foundries were to cast our future, but they are turned on us. And once his shield's down, the DPS come in. The reason we do that is because if we don't do that, they'll get life burn stacks for nothing. And Cob Rising Flames, that's it, you can impair that. And there's another one he does where it says reduction or something like that. You want to impair that as well. Otherwise, you don't have to do anything. Cob Rising Flames you need, and that reduction thing. I never know what the name is. I know what their animation looks like. These days, I don't even read the text, to be honest. Okay, so once the group's ready, what I usually say is jump when your sprint is on. So I'm going to jump, make sure everybody jumps. And we're not going to stop until we're in the well. Okay, going in 5 seconds. And we just keep going. Don't stop till we're in the well. And don't resurrect until everybody's dead. Because you find you'll resurrect and then the mobs will be killing the dude next to you and then you'll die. Then you'll die again and then you'll resurrect again. It's so painful. Just stay dead until everybody's dead. Gives me some vital time to respond to some of my tell messages. There we are, everybody's dead. Gonna fix my gear. So that's another thing. When you die, remember to repair. Sometimes I'm in there, all my gear's broken, and I'm like, why is my DPS so rubbish? So now is the time we need that build that has contortionist. So we need to go back, remember to go, I always usually start the fight, realize I'm in the wrong build, then we die, and then I swap back again. Just a bad habit. Okay, we're all here. So who's going to run? I recommend going Fist for the healer. HB is going to run. Whenever you're ready, Honey Beaver, you can go and then we'll run in there. What I do is, there's nothing to impair. It's a matter of taking the boss to this left-hand side sort of corner all the way down. Okay, go HB. The power relay. Our enemy could choose no more strategic nor military. Gotta make sure that the DPSs don't fully attack. And then we just bring the boss down here. I've got to reload you up. And now we just stand here. Now what you're going to do is, you're going to get this column attack on you that's going to hinder the shit out of you. Okay, something's not cool here. I know what that is. Runner died. So let me just explain that, because I didn't get a chance to explain the full mechanics over there. So what's going to happen is the boss is going to do like a column attack, which is going to hinder you. Your contortionist is going to take care of the first hinder, then the second hinder, you're going to use your sleight of hand. Then contortionist is going to do the third one, sleight of hand is going to do the fourth one. They timed in such a way that contortionist can't do all of them. It's contortionist 1, sleight of hand 2, contortionist 3, sleight of hand 4, and so forth. That's the technique, that's the method. Quick reload my UI. There we are. We're looking good now. Okay, are you ready, Honey Beaver?
Sure.
I'll just reset. That's a nice reset trick that I just did there. I don't know if you caught that. I don't want to go now because that boss will see me and then he'll whip my ass. But yeah, you just stand sort of 3/4 the way through this blue shield and then you'll reset the dogs and you don't have to die. Okay, get in there, Honey Beaver. Okay, the runner waited too long. I have to reset it again. There we are, they reset. You see how I did that? What kills tanks in this fight is purely not getting the contortionist sleight of hand thing right. It's very simple. You'll see exactly how I do it. Anyone can do it. Yep, we're ready. Whenever you're ready, you can go. I've made it so you guys can't hear my team speak for this fight because there's a lot going on. gonna be... That's my contortionist first. I like to stand in this corner, like properly in the corner. Then what's gonna happen is the boss is gonna go just out of your reach. So you go forward. See, I can't attack from here. You have to step forward, then the boss will move back, and then you move back, and then the boss will come to you. So sleight of hand. Make sure to go sideways out of it and go completely out of it, because the attack is a little bit larger than what the, that dash shows, or that column attack shows. See, I'm not in range, so I go forward. It's like forward, back, forward, back. There we are. Now I go back and the boss will come forward. Technically, I could go here and then teach the boss a lesson. The key is to make it so sleight of hand. See, it's quite a long cast, so you have plenty of time. The run is dead. The run is dead. Tell them to... Oh god, it's too late. We're dead. No, we're gonna wipe it. Okay, waiting for the runner. As soon as you're ready, HP, boss is in position. What I do is I don't hit agitation configuration until I'm in the corner. I usually tell my DPSs to hold off damage until I get here. See, now I hit the agitation. Contortionist took care of that. You can test it. Just try run side to side. See if you can get out of it. See, I keep going forwards and backwards to maintain my distance to the boss. See, sleight of hand. Next one will be contortionist. If we live that long. Contortionist took care of that. And the boss is dead. Easy as that. I like to mark these. I say red, green, then blue. And the reason I do that is because even though I run with 10.9 people, they more often than not still kill the wrong boss in the wrong order. I don't know how that happens, but it does. As a tank, you only want Brutus selected, and the only thing you want to impair is drink deep. Nothing else matters. Drink deep, impair that. So we are running a new healer. So if we die a few times, then you know why. It's no biggie, because I like to have my peeps do different roles sometimes. It sucks to do the same thing every time, you know what I mean. That's why you're watching this video, so you can learn to tank and do something other than DPS or leech. We're just waiting for our DPSs. So what I like to tell my DPSs is everybody needs sleight of hand. So when you get the chains, you can sleight of hand yourself and then you're free. Never stop running when you're on fire. And when Brutus does body hammer, everybody wants to stack up and get right in there. If one person doesn't stack and everybody else does, someone's gonna die. He'll just pick a random dude, kill the dude, and then the fight will continue. So everybody hugs on body hammer, everybody has sleight of hand for the chains, and everybody runs when they're on fire. And you want to impair drink deep. That's it. Okay, I'm just going to relay to my DPS group that I'm all ready. And let's go. So keep Brutus selected. There's drink deep, impair that. Some people say don't use AoE impairs, to be honest I don't care, I just use them. Pain wheel overdrive, move out of that. On the next fight you have to impair that. Don't even worry about what the DPSs are doing. As long as you keep Brutus selected, you're in good, sort of, you're good. Body hammer, stack up. Ooh, we were so lucky. Mephisto's reach. On Mephisto's reach, you want to sort of rocket launch and get as far away as possible, but run on the outside, the very outside of the room. Otherwise his AoE will end up killing the trigger happy DPSs and they'll be too close to the boss and then they'll just die. And that's no good when that happens.
Go. We shall meet at the summit.
That was pretty smooth.
How very human.
So what I like to do here is I like to do what we call tanking version 2.0. So what we do is the DPSs all stand over here where I'm jumping. Then what's going to happen is as the tank, I'll run over here. Don't lose your sprint. You're just going to run around here like that, pick the boss up, and you're going to bring him around this pillar. Don't let him come straight here. He wants to go around the pillar. The key is your feet must be touching the back of this. See, I can't walk backwards anymore. I'm literally touching the wall. And the reason you do that is so you don't get shadow in the blood. If you get shadow in the blood, it's pretty much a guaranteed wipe. You can't impair it. There's nothing you can do. You need to be touching the back, whether it's a wall over there, or it's a wall over there, or it's an edge of a wall over here. You need to be with your back against something. So, and this is where we do it. So we fight over here. He'll do the red bombs. Once he's done the red bombs, as a tank, I'm going to go straight to this wall over here. Again, make sure you're touching the wall. I can't go more back than that. Then I'm going to continue the fight here. The red bombs stop about here, so the DPSs can stand here and attack from here. So rather than running all the way to here and missing out on all that DPS, I go to this wall here. And then the DPSs can DPS a lot sooner, thus kill the boss a lot faster. Then what's going to happen is he'll suck us to the middle. Once he's sucked us to the middle, I'm going to turn and rocket launch straight back to this wall. And I'm going to wait here for the boss. Then the boss is going to stay over there where my mouse pointer is. And he's slowly going to run all the way back here. It'll take him ages to get to me. And that whole trip back is free DPS. The DPS can just beat the shit out of him until he gets here. Then he'll suck us straight back in again. You want to impair drink deep, and you want to impair pain wheel overdrive when he sucks us in the middle. Those are the only things you want to impair. You need 3 impairs for this fight. Don't rely on the whip, because the whip glances too much. It needs to be a proper weapon. Okay, and that's pretty much it. So we'll get our DPSs in position. I'll jump a few times to signal that I'm ready. Yep, they know what that means, since they can't hear me. But my wife is sat next to me, and she's the one jumping over there now, that one over there. So she's relaying my messages to them. So I'm going to go and pick the boss up. So you just run past him, don't attack him. Make sure you lead him around this wall. He wants to go exactly here, and the reason why is because if he's attacking you head on, like say from the side over here, you'll get shadow in the blood because the back of you isn't touching the wall. If that makes sense. So now we're going to rocket launch to our position. Your DPSs need sleight of hand for this, once again. And now I just wait here. Same thing. Back's touching the wall. As long as the DPS isn't afflicting, he wouldn't have died, so it's good. Now he's going to suck us in the middle. Drink deep, impair that. Here we are. Now he sucked us in. DPS need to be careful on the shield. So pain wheel overdrive, that's what you're looking for in here. If you see that, impair it. I think that's our healer dead. Luckily I've got a good leech potion down here, so that should keep me alive long enough, hopefully. See how long it's taking him to get here. That's all free DPS going on there. And now it begins again. Lens, this is gonna hurt. Time for a leech potion. And he does. Easy as that. And I can't think of anything else to tell you. He never did the pain wheel overdrive, so you couldn't see that cost. But generally he would do a pain wheel overdrive. It's a giant circular attack, and you need to impair that because it's either that or the DPSs run into the sort of like the bombs and stuff. Pain wheel overdrive. That's it. Any messages, drop them down below. Any questions, gear questions or tactics issues or anything like that. Or even if you just want a regular chat, just pop it down below and you know we can have a chat. Or if you want to do dungeons with us, no worries, just message me in-game. You can see my name, Princess Hyphen Lexi. You just send me a message on there. And yeah, we can do some dungeons or something. It'll be fun. No worries. That's it. Catch you later.